Millennials are having serious FOMO. You know the acronym, fear of missing out. No one wants FOMO, especially savvy millennials. Catch this, some 60% of millennials aren't investing in the stock market. Let's be honest, college vacuums up every last dollar in our pockets, so you might not be thinking about putting money toward investing. But hear me out, investing even a small amount of money as a college student in the stock market could save you tens or even hundreds of thousands of dollars. What's my point? Take advantage of time and compounding interest. It works this way. Assuming at 17 years old, you begin investing $15 a month into an index fund with an annual rate of return of 7%. If you retire at 67 years old, you would have approximately $82,000 and change. If you wait even 4 years and begin investing at 21, you could lose out on more than $20,000. And this is based on specific assumptions about the monthly payment and the average annual rate of return. You'll likely be able to set aside more than $15 a month as your pay increases over your career, meaning these numbers could be dramatically higher. Now that I have your attention, let's talk about how to invest. There are many different ways to get started. Some experts say investing in low-cost index funds and ETFs is smart for the long term as part of a set-it-and-forget-it strategy. That's because they require less maintenance due to their relatively low volatility. This isn't a get-rich-quick strategy, but you could see your wealth grow over time exponentially. Mutual funds and ETFs are baskets of securities, some of which track the major stock market indexes like the S&P 500, the NASDAQ, and the Dow Jones Industrial Average. They can also do a lot of other things, including track specific sectors like retail, software, or tech, or even other asset classes like commodities or bonds. Unlike an individual stock, a fund like this automatically gives you the benefit of diversification. Let's define this real quick. Diversification involves the mixing of different types of investments within a portfolio and is used to manage risk. So why does investing matter? Well, a whopping 2/3 of millennials have nothing saved for retirement. And although retirement may seem a ways away, experts suggest to start saving now, especially if you want to spend your 60s traveling or spending time on the beach. You may be wondering, wait, how do I even get started with investing? Great question. First, you need some cash flow. This might mean cutting out some of your Starbucks runs. Next, you need to create your brokerage account. Don't freak out, it's like creating any other account. You don't need to buy right away. You can simply create your account and wait until you are ready to begin purchasing shares. There are many different websites you can use. You may have heard of Robinhood, E-Trade, or TD Ameritrade, to name just a few. Next, think about how many shares to buy and do not be afraid to start small. Remember, this is about starting early. You do not need hundreds of thousands of dollars or even thousands of dollars to start investing. What is important is that you are starting early. Finally, start buying your shares and building your portfolio. FOMO isn't fun. We all know that. But by harnessing the power of time when you are young, you could see your wealth grow exponentially. For Investor's Business Daily, I'm Zoe Ginsberg.